Hi, welcome to RameshSoft video tutorials. In this tutorial, we are going to talk about prepared statement and result set interfaces. In order to send and execute the queries, we will use prepared statement. How to get a prepared statement object and what is the use of this prepared statement object when compared with the statement interface. Now, whenever we want to execute the SQL query many times, then we use prepared statement object. Prepared statement object accepts input parameters at runtime. In prepared statement, database engine only performs first time compilation activity. Next time onwards, it won't perform like a query tokenization, query processing, query optimization and query execution, so that performance will be improved. When it comes to static statement interface, whenever we use statement interface to execute our SQL queries, each and every time on each and every execution of that SQL query, query tokenization will be done, query processing and query optimization and query executing will be performed. But when it comes to prepared statement, only first time this activity is going to be done. From next time onwards, it won't perform any query optimization, query tokenization, query processing and query execution. With this, performance will be improved. So, how to get prepared statement object? So, we can get a prepared statement object whenever we call prepared statement method on connection object, we are going to get a prepared statement object. So this prepared statement object is going to accept SQL queries with input parameters. This input parameters we need to pass at runtime. Now, see here, prepared statement will send our command to database and then the compiled code will be stored in prepared statement object. To send SQL command for compilation, only syntax of the command line is required, but not values. So we take this question mark symbol in place of values. This question mark we can also call as a positional symbol or positional symbol or replacement operator or place resolution operator. So these values we can pass at runtime as a part of this query execution. To set the values in place of positional parameters, we call set xxx methods. So we can call what? Set xxx methods. Now see here, some rules are there to use this question mark symbol. So question mark symbol cannot be used in DDL operations. It can be used only in insert, update, select, delete. That is CRUD operations, CRUD operations. Now second point, question mark symbol cannot be used to replace column names and table names. It can be used to replace values. That's it. Okay. So what are the rules? See here, rules on question marks. See here that positional symbols. So create table ID int. It is invalid. Now, second one, select from table name. It is also invalid. So, which one is valid? Now, see here, let me write this sample program. Select star from table name where salary less than C equal to question mark. Now it is what? Valid. Now it is valid. Now here one more. Insert into table name column 1 comma column 2 values. How many are there? Two columns are there. Now it is what? valid. Okay, now see here. Let me discuss syntaxes. So how we need to use this question mark symbols. Okay, now let me see the sample syntaxes. Let's see here, all I have written here. So for inserting, insert into table name, how many columns, any number of columns depends on your table, and values with what, question marks. So this question marks values for this question marks when we can pass at runtime. Okay, at runtime. Now see here, let's implement a sample example so that we can understand what exactly things are going to happen. Now let me write create a class, new class prepared statement JDBC demo. Now first let me write the main method, main main method, and write the class dot for name method. So here I'm going to use type 4 driver. So it is throwing checked exception, handle it. I think color it is there in my previous. Let me do copy paste. Already we are very familiar with these steps. Yes. Can it is showing checked exception, handle it. So here with this first line, I am loading that driver class, and the second one I am creating, I am establishing what, connection between our Java application and database. Now connection is ready. Now I need to send the queries to the database. Yes. In order to send database to the queries, we have three interfaces: statement interface, prepared statement interface, callable statement interface. Now let me get a connection interface connection. Let me get prepared statement object. On that connection object, call prepare statement. Here let me write the query. I am writing insert into, what is my table name, I think JDBC test. JDBC test. Here I am having two columns, id comma name. For this, what are the values I want to pass it, question mark comma question mark. How many columns are there? Two columns. So we need to pass how many placeholders here, positional parameters, two. For this we need to pass the values at what, at a runtime. Okay, at runtime. And to set the values in place of these positional parameters, we should call set xxx methods of prepared statement. To get these values, we need to call get xxx methods of prepared statement. So I want to take these values through scanner class. So scanner, let me create scanner class object to read the values from keyboard through scanner system dot in. Now so syso enter a number. Now a scanner dot, already we know this as a part of core Java, scanner dot next int. So I am going to get, what is the value now, integer int id. Now syso of enter a string. Now read that string, scanner dot next. So I'm going to get a string name. Now I want to pass these values to what, my positional parameters. So for that we are having what, set xx methods of prepared statement. That is, this prepared statement is having methods like set int, set float, set double, set string, something like it is having some methods. Now see here, now I am going to get here prepared statement. Set the values ps dot set int. So here parameter index indicates column number, first column, and what is the value you want to place it here. What is the value? ID. Next one, prepared statement dot, I want to set the value string, which position? Second position. What is the value? Name. Yes, now execute it. How can I execute it? Prepared statement dot execute method. Execute method. Yes, now again, if you want, you can set what? Multiple values, like again SYSO of enter values, enter a number. How many values you want to second? I am not setting any values here. If you want, you can set what? Multiple values. Let me hard code it this time. Prepared statement dot set int of first one. Now here I am adding like 258. Now prepared statement dot set a string of, now here I am adding real time. Now let me execute this one. Prepared statement dot execute method. Let me write here SYSO for logging purpose. Record is inserted. This is first record. Now here I am writing SYSO of second record is inserted. Let me run this program. See here what is going to happen. Right click, run as Java application. Enter a number, it is asking. I am entering 45. It is asking enter a string. I am entering Ramesh soft software solutions. Click on enter. Now see here, first record is inserted, second record is inserted, right? So this is what exactly about prepared statement object. So whenever you want to execute the queries multiple number of times, then we can go for prepared statement. And this prepared statement won't take any static values. We can pass that inputs at a runtime, that is at dynamically, in the form of place resolution operator or in the form of positional symbols. And also, if you use prepared statement interface, the performance will be improved, because this query optimization, processing and tokenization execution is going to be happened at the first time. Again, when we are executing from the next time onwards, it won't happen, so that performance will be improved. Now, next one, we are going to talk about result set interface. So what is result set interface? What is the use of this result set interface? Now see here, result set is an interface which is there as the part of java.sql.package. By using this result set object, we can hold data that is fetched from the database. So the object of result set maintains a cursor pointing to a row of table. Initially, cursor always points to the before first row. Okay, again I'm telling, the object of result set maintains a cursor pointing to a row of a table. Initially, cursor points to before the first row. Okay, whenever we fetching the data from database, so whenever we are executing the queries like select queries, it always returns that data in the form of result set object. Okay, see here, whenever we want to perform select operations, we have one method called execute query method. So this execute query method always returns what? Result set object, that is result set interface. So based on our query, it fetches the data from the database and it maintains in where? In this result set. Okay, see here, what are the methods are there in this result set interface? Result set interface, that we are going to use commonly. So commonly used methods of result set interface we'll discuss now, and then we'll go for one example so that we'll understand. Now we having a method called public boolean next method. By using this method, we can move the cursor to the one row next from the cursor current position. That is, first, whenever we have result set object, always the cursor points to what? Before first row. The moment I call next method, it moves from that position to what? First row. Again, let us think that the cursor is pointing to the first row. The moment we call next method, again it is going to move to what? Next row. If the row is there, if the data is there, it returns true. If the data is not there, it returns false. Next one. We'll discuss in detail. Next one. One more method is there. Public boolean previous. Same. Like if you want to move previous, that is, this method is used to move the cursor to the one row previous from the current position. Okay. Next one. One more method is there, public boolean first. So whenever we call this method will move the cursor to the first row in the result set object. The same way, whenever we call public boolean last, this method will move the cursor to the what? Last row in the result set object. Now, in order to get the data from the result set, we are having getter methods. We are having getter methods like get xxx methods. So in place of xxx, we can pass that column data type. Let me write it sample public int get int method. Here we need to pass int column index. We'll see one by one, don't worry. In the same way, we have public string get string method, and in the same way we have, if you want to get the float to double values, float get float and etc. Okay, we'll see one by one. Now we'll see practically one by one. Next one, we have different types of result sets are available. That is, we have three different types of result sets are there. The first one is result set dot type underscore forward underscore only. So this result set makes the cursor can only move forward in the result set. That is, we have three types of result sets are there. Let me write it result set and dot type underscore forward underscore only. With this type, the cursor can only move forward in the result set. So by default, whenever we are using result set, if we do not specify any result set type, you will automatically get this result set type. If you don't specify any result set type, automatically we'll get what? This result set type. So this result set type means that the cursor can only move forward in the result set. Okay. Now, I want to forward, like I want to make my cursor scroll forward and backward. Then we have such kind of requirement. We need to use this kind of result set. Result set dot type underscore scroll underscore insensitive. With this result set type, the cursor can scroll forward and backward, and the result set is not sensitive to changes made by others database that occur after the result set was created. But mainly, by using this result set type, the cursor can scroll forward and backward. Okay, and one more result set is there. So that is not important. Basically, we use in the maximum as a QA people, we use what? This type underscore forward underscore only. We are not required to specify explicitly. Whenever we are getting result set object, by default, it uses internally this type of result set only. Okay, and one more concept is there in result set. What is that means? Concurrency of result set. That is, if you do not specify any concurrency type, you will automatically get one type, that is concur underscore read underscore only. That is, it creates a read only result set. I mean, this is the default one. So we cannot perform any updation operations, etc. Now see here, concurrency of result set. Now see here. So we have two types of concurrency types of result set is there. First one is result set dot concur concur underscore read underscore only with this one. So creates a read only result set. This is a default one. Like, we cannot perform updation of this result set and etc. If you want to update, if you want to create an updatable result set, then we need to use this concurrency of result set. See here, result set dot concur underscore updatable. So by using this result set, we can perform what? Updatable operations on result set as well. But mostly it is not required. Basically, we use always this result set dot concur underscore read only. It is a default one. For you QA people, it is not required. Just as a part of discussions, I am talking about this. But if you know well and good, it will be very helpful in the interview purpose. Now let me write a sample example. See here, statement is equal to connection dot create statement. So when we are creating statement object here, we need to specify that what type of result set you want to use, what type of concurrency of result set you want to use. Okay, now see here, so by default, if you don't specify anything, the result set is of type what? Result set dot type underscore forward. If you want, you can specify as well. Control V, comma. If you want, you can specify what you want to make it only read only, or you want to make it what updatable only. If you want, you can specify here. Now, whenever you get result set object, now it is of type what? Result set dot type underscore forward only. And what is the concurrence type? Updatable. Okay. Just I'm talking. So by default, if you don't specify, by default the type is become what? This is the type, result set dot type underscore forward underscore only. Okay, now see here, let me write a sample example using this result set so that we'll get idea. Now see here, so in the previous example just now we saw, right? So with the prepared statement, what we are doing, we are inserting the values. Now I want to get back that values. I want to retrieve that values. So prepared statement dot, here we are performing select operations, right? If you want to perform select operations, we need to use the method called execute query. Write the query, select star from, what is my table name? JDBC test. So always this execute query method returns that results from database in the form of what? Result set. Now let me write it here, result set. This result set by default, what type of result it is? We are not specifying anything. So by default, this will become what? What is the type? This is become result set dot type underscore forward only. With this, creates a read-only result set object. This is the default one if you don't specify anything. And what is the concurrency of result set type by default? Result set dot concur underscore read-only. Okay, now see here. So now this result set is having what? A group of records. So always in result set, the cursor points to what? Before the first row. Yes, I want to make it to next row. We have one method called, what is that method? Next method. If the data is available, this method returns what? True. Else it returns false. If the data is there, I want to get the data from that rows. How can we get it? we have get xxx methods. Already we discussed just now. Now see here, let me write the while loop. While result set dot next method. If the row is there, it will move it to wait. Next row, if the row is there, it returns true. Else it returns false. If the row is there, give me the data. So for that result set dot result set dot get my first row is of type what? First column, give the column number, column index, first column. Now I'm going to get what? That first column in that row, first column I'm going to get it into something id 1. Next result set dot get the string second one. Wait, what? Now here string one. Let me print SYSO of ID 1, SYSO of name 1. That's it. Now let me run this program. Run as Java application. Now it's asking enter a number. I'm entering 456. Enter a string. Now I'm entering Java with Selenium in practical approach. Click on enter. Now see here. So 4567 and Java and real time. I'm getting it or not? Yes. So this is the what? Exactly. What is the use of prepared statement and what is the use of result set in JDBC? Okay. So I hope you people understood, and thanks for watching the video. Have a good day.